Hello everyone, today we are going to continue the subject of network analysis. In that, the chapter is of a series resonance circuitry. So here the series resonance numerical is mentioned here. A RLC series circuit has a resistance of 100 ohm. L is equals to 0.5 Henry. The maximum current flow through it at a frequency of 40 Hertz. If the supply is 100 volt at a 50 cycles per second. CPS is nothing but cycle per second. First of all, find the parameters are mentioned here. What you need to find I, that is the current, PF, that is power factor, and the voltage drop across the each element. So if you observe this numerical, you will identify this numerical is related on the series resonance circuitry. It means that the R, L and C are connected in series. Okay, so and the values are also mentioned. The R is mentioned as 100, L is nothing but 0.5 Henry, okay. And the frequency is mentioned as a 40 Hertz. You need to calculate the current. You need to calculate the power factor. And you need to calculate the VR, VL and the VC. Voltage drop across the resistor, inductor and the capacitor. So how we can start? We can start here. The resonance frequency, that is nothing but denoted by F0. Resonance frequency F0 in the series circuit can be calculated 1 divided by 2 pi root of LC. Why we are going to calculate this one? Because we don't have the value of the capacitor in this case. We have L, we have R, but we don't have C. So squaring, note on here, squaring on both the side. If we are taking squaring on both the side, at that time you will be able to find the C. C will be equal, C will become here. C will be equals to 1 by this 4 pi square, okay, L into F0 square. So substitute the value of all here, 4 pi square into what is the value of L? L is nothing but your the 0.5 into what is your the F0, that is the frequency, that is nothing but the 40 whole square. If you do with the calc, you will be able to find the answer, that is 1 divided by 4 pi square into 40 square into 0.5 is nothing but 31.66 microfarad. So this is one parameter you have calculated. The second step is nothing but what is also mentioned, that is a what we can say 100 volt is mentioned, that is nothing but V is equals to 100 volt is mentioned here. So now the second parameter at a what we can say 50 cycles per second, okay, that is also mentioned, 50 cycles per second, okay. Now we need to calculate here the current, how we can calculate the current, that we will see later on. Before that we will go through the reactances. What is that? Inductive reactance and capacitive reactance. How we can calculate the inductive reactance and the capacitive reactance? The inductive reactance can be calculated as XL is equals to omega L. And we know that omega is nothing but 2 pi F. And this L will be as it is. So 2 pi into 40 into 0.5. Okay. 2 pi into 40 into that frequency is mentioned here. Especially they mention the condition. Especially they mentioned if the supply is 100 volt at the 50 cycles per second. So here what you need to take, you need to take the 50 cycles per second, and that too inductor is nothing but the 0.5, 2 pi into 50 into what you can say 0.5. so with the help of calc you will be able to find 157.08 ohm. 157.08 ohm is nothing but inductive reactance. Similarly, capacitive reactance is 1 by omega C. So here 1 by 2 pi FC. 1 by 2 pi FC. Again, 1 by what is F? 50 cycles per second. So 50 here. What you have found the capacitor value? 31.66 micro 10 raised to the power minus 6 is here. So here the capacitive reactance will be XC 100.50 ohm. Okay, now the current, how we can calculate the current with the help of the Ohm's law? I is equals to V by E. Z you need to take. Why we are taking here the Z? Just because of the RLC circuit combination. So what is the V or you can say E by Z, okay, V or E by Z. So what is my E? That is nothing but the 100 is mentioned, and what is the Z? Z is nothing but, we know very well in the impedances Z can be written as R plus J of X. But if you want to take the magnitude, at that time this mod Z will be equals to root of first term square and second term square, that is nothing but R square and X square. Here the X is nothing but the XL and XC. So which is greater? The XL is greater than the XC. That's why what you need to take here, what you need to take here, that is a root of, you can say root of, the formula will become as root of r square plus xl minus xc square, r square minus xl minus xc whole square. So just substitute. So what will be my case, the 100 divided by, what is my r? My r is nothing but 100 plus, what is my xl? Xl is 157.08 minus, what is my xc? 100.5, okay, whole square. So with the help of calc, the current will come here, 0.87 ampere is the current. So you need to calculate the current with the help of the impedance. Next is nothing but voltage drop across the each component. So we are having RLC. So voltage drop across resistor, inductor and the capacitor. So V is equals to by the Ohm's law. Now the last parameter you can calculate, that is the voltage drop across the resistor, inductor and the capacitor. How we can calculate? By the Ohm's law, V is equals to IR. So voltage drop across the inductor will be IR. Voltage drop across the resistor is the IR. Inductor will be I into XL. And the capacitor is nothing but I into XC. Substitute the value here. What will happen? The current you got as 0.87 into. Here also 0.87. Here also 0.87. So for the resistor value is 100 ohm. And inductive reactance is 157.08. And the capacitive reactance is 100.5. So you will get the answer with the help of the calc. First is nothing but your the voltage drop across the resistor is 136.6. Here voltages are there, so the unit will be the volt, and the